ראש השנה, 4th chapter, 7th משנה. העובר לפני התיבה ביום טוב של ראש השנה, עובר לפני התיבה, the sometimes passes in front of the ark, means the chazan. The chazan of the יום טוב of ראש השנה, היינו שליח הציבור, השני, it means the second one. What's the second one? So there's two שליח ציבור. There's one that davens shachris, and the one that davens musaf. זה שמתפלל תפילת מוסף, the one that davens מוסף. מתקיע את התקיעות על סדר הברכות. He blows the shofar, he doesn't blow. מתקיע, he tells, he gives the instruction to blow the shofar. Yeah, על סדר הברכות, with the blessings. And what's that strange? לא הראשון המתפלל תפילת שחרית. It's not the first one who davens shachrit. L'chura, you should do the shofar in shachris already. Just the way we do it in Musaf. We should do it in shachris. He says, no, we don't do it in shachris. We do it in Musaf. Why Musaf? Bagmara mevoar, in the Gemara it explains, שבראשונה היו תוקים בתפילת שחרית. It says, actually, you should do it in shachris. Why shachris? מקדימים למצוות. The first opportunity, you have the mitzvah, do it in the first opportunity. So do it in shachris. And he says, that's the way it was. In the beginning, they used to do it in shachris. Ad she'ira ma'aseh, until something historical happened. In the time of the Romans, what happened? In the time of the Romans, they were not allowed to... There was decrees of the Romans. And chashdu bahem ha-Romayim, the Romans were suspicious of them. Shayu tok'im le-mered. It says they didn't know. There were a new bunch that came into town. You know, a new pluga, a new platoon came into town. They heard a shofar. They said, hey, the shofar was also used to arouse the masses as a sign of war. So they thought the Jews are starting war on them. So what happened? Ve'amdu alehem ve'hargum. And they killed them. Because they heard the shofar, they came into the... So they're attacking. So they attacked back and they killed a lot of Jews. Oto sha'a itkinu shiyu tok'im betfilat Musaf. So the sages changed it from shachris to Musaf at that time. How's Musaf going to help? U'mitoch sh'ra'u ha'oivim sh'oskim t'chila betfila u'bikriyat ha'torah. Now the new platoon said, look, the whole morning they're in shul, they're davening, they're doing their things.
Start of the davening.
Yeah. And only then they blow the shofar. הבינו שתקיעות של מצווה הן ולא של מלחמה. They understood this tkiyos, this blowing of the shofar is for the mitzvah and not for war. מכאן שאין תוקים אלא במוסף. So from here started that we only blow the shofar in Musaf. Even though it should be done when? Shachris. וזהו ששנינו. And another one, it's a strange way to say it. It says, השני תוקע. You notice that? Over here it says, השני מתקיע. Yeah, well, תוקע means he blows. מתקיע means he makes somebody else blows. So it says, השני מתקיע, the second one, the second chazan, he's the one who causes the shofar, שאף בימיהם, that also in their days, נהגו כבימינו. It was like in our days. In other words, it wasn't the chazan who blows the shofar. Yeah? It was somebody else who blows the shofar. להעמיד שליח ציבור אחד לשחרית, ושליח ציבור אחד למוסף. They were, just like in our day, the custom is to have someone who davened shachris and a different sum for Musaf. ומה שנקטה משנתנו לשון מתקיע. So why did it say מתקיע? It should say תוקע. פירש רב היגאון, רב היגאון explain, לפי שאין שליח ציבור רשאי לתקוע על סדר הברכות. It says the chazan is not allowed to blow the shofar. Why? Because he is busy davening. Remember the rule, we already said it. The davening then wasn't like our davening. What do you mean it wasn't like our davening? He was giving a blueprint. But what he said in the blueprint, he decides. So he needs to think about, you know, this village yesterday was a hurricane. It wasn't a hurricane another. So he's davening for the hurricane. Yeah. Exactly. He has to think about that. Yeah. שמה יתרד ולא יוכל לכוון ליבו לחזור לתפילתו. So you can get confused, the davening, this. No, you have one job, think about your davening, somebody else is going to blow the shofar. אלא אחר צריך לתקוע, but somebody else needs to blow the shofar. ופירוש מתקיע, and it says מתקיע, he causes somebody else to blow, נותן לתוקע שיתקע בין הברכות. He gives the one who blows the shofar that he is going to blow the shofar.
And we do it until today.
ובשעת הלל, what about הלל? הלל is also extra. So the question is, why don't you give somebody else הלל? We give the chazan to say הלל. בשעה שומרים הלל, היינו בשאר יומים טובים, in other holidays, הראשון, שליח הציבור הראשון, מתפלל תפילת שחרית, מי מקרא את הלל? So he reads the הלל. You remember, their הלל was a little bit like us, it was back and forth. Between the, he was read, like we do. You know, we repeat after him certain verses. But in that time, there was more back and forth than in our time. קורא את ההלל לפני הקהל. He used to read the הלל in front of the congregation. והם עונים אחריו, הללוקה. And they say, used to say, הללוקה, after every verse. שם הבאנו את במפורט של הרמב״ם, מנהג בקעת כהל בימיהם. This was the custom in their times, not like our custom. Like after every sentence, we would answer הללוקה. Okay. משתתלנו נקעה ובשעת ההלל, our mission says, at the time of the הלל, לפי שבראש השנה וביום הכיפורים אין אומרים הלל. It's because in ראש השנה and יום כיפור there's no הלל. והתאמו, why did ראש השנה and יום כיפורים there's no הלל? It's a holiday. Should we say הלל? משום שהוא זמן החלעת הלב ולא זמן שירה. It says, הלל is when you are happy. You're in a תנועה, you're in a movement of joy. Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur is a more serious tone. You have the king in front of you. You know, you don't sing in front of the king. וכן מבואר בגמרא, also it explains in the Gemara, אפשר מלך יושב על כיסא דין, it says the king is over here now, it's middle of court. Yeah, the king is sitting on the court. וספרי חיים וספרי מתים פתוחים לפניו, and the books of life, the books of death, he's in front of him. בישראל אומרים שירה, now you're singing? That's not an appropriate time for singing. ממה שמבואר בגמרא לרישא של משנתנו, from the fact that the Gemara talks about the beginning of a Mishnah, שבתחילה היו תוקעים בתפילת שחרית, that in the beginning, they used to blow specifically on שחרית, not like we do today, יש למדים, there are those who learn, שגם בתפילת שחרית של ראש השנה היו נוהגים לומר מלכויות, זיכרונות ושופרות. Which means that we do on Musaf all the 10 verses that they did, that we do on Musaf, all the 10 verses, Malchuyot, like we learned before, they used to do the 10 verses in Shachris also. So they used to do it also in Shachris. שהרי התקיעות על סדר הברכות הללו, because the tkias, when you blow the shofar, is according to those verses. ואומנם לדעת בעל המאור, according to the opinion of the בעל המאור, אמרו בתחילה 9 ברכות בכל התפילות בראש השנה. So he says, yes, that's true. The Musaf, our Musaf, was actually also the same as the verses was also in Shachris. בין בערבית, בין בשחריס, בין במוסף, בין במנחה. They used to say all the 10 verses in all davenings, not just like we do only in Musaf. כלומר, שהברכות האמצעיות היו מלכויות, that the middle blessings were מלכויות, זיכרונות ושופרות. So we didn't have the regular shachris, but with the middle, after the three first ones, then they have kiddush hayom, the Rosh Hashanah, and then they will have the 10 verses, and then they will continue back to the shachris. ברם תקיעות לא היו להם מוסף, כפורש, אבל הרמב"ן חולק על בעל המאור, the Rambam disagrees on בעל המאור, הוא מביא ראיה מן הירושלמי שתשע נהם ברכות לא נראו במוסף. He says, no, it wasn't done in Shachris, it wasn't in Mincha, it wasn't done in Ma'ariv, it was only done in Musaf, just like us. I don't know where he got the... That was the argument.